Good morning, gentlemen. I have here what I consider a groundbreaking sandwich. I believe it was available in, not in the United States, I'm almost positive of that. But finally it became available here in the States. And what we are looking at here is a chicken donut sandwich by KFC. And we have, this is incredible, man. This is too much to believe, right? It is two glazed donuts on top of a chicken sandwich. I don't know how I'm going to be able to maneuver this, but I'm going to try, trust me. So this is not a Krispy Kreme donut, it's a glazed donut. And you can see some of the glaze drippings is pouring onto the chicken. Now, let me just explain something to you. Years ago, and I'm going back years ago, this would be unheard of, okay? The same way that burritos have taken over the breakfast plates in the last 10 to 12 years, where you're eating burritos and all kinds of other shit that you should be eating for lunch or dinner on top of eggs. Like, you know, this is the same thing as pineapples on pizza. I mean, it's just totally outrageous. I'm just waiting for this to cool down a bit because it's piping hot and it's just came right off the grill. It looks tempting. It really looks nice. I'm wondering if Popeyes is going to follow suit and do something similar. What I'm pleased about this is the fact that it didn't have any, like, social media Twitter wars with the sandwich. So, you know, to make it unavailable, and then people will be stabbing and excuse me, shooting each other to get a sandwich. And that's what basically happened with I get some water. That's what happened with you know, Popeyes. Got some casualties for a fucking chicken sandwich. So this is going to be quite interesting. I might actually finish the whole thing instead of just giving like a little bit of a taste test. But anyway, let's, without further ado, let's see if I could maneuver this. Okay, so we got, still hot, man, and the glazed, wow, you still have the glaze from the donut dripping into the sandwich. This is a first, no doubt. So actually what I was expecting was the donut to take center stage from the, and you know, actually take over the flavor instead of the chicken, but it's actually blending in with the tender itself. So I don't know, let me see if I could take another bite of this. But I'm getting everything, you know. It's like they sort of knew what they were doing when they put the sandwich together, because, you know, they figured how are you gonna put two donuts and connect that to a chicken sandwich. It's like, you know, the donuts are for dessert and the chicken is for you know, your regular meal, your lunch meal, whatever. Now, I'm sure there are some that are, like, probably eating the chicken sandwich first and then saving the donuts for dessert. But this is probably the most... Then you'd be, you know what? You'd be defeating the whole purpose if you decide to do something like that. Because then it's not a chicken donut sandwich anymore. It's really not bad. You know, they try to be creative. They took a gamble by replacing the bun with the donut. Will it work? Only time, it just remains to be seen. Only time will tell. But you get to lick the glaze off the donut while you're eating the sandwich. That's pretty cool, huh? It's nice and juicy. I mean, you know, this is not a chicken sandwich. This is not a Popeye's chicken sandwich. It's a KFC, so you don't get that real crunch or the tasty meat that they put out. It's still good though. I like it. See, a lot of people would mistake it. People, like when you hear that they're putting out a donut sandwich in the middle of, with a piece of chicken tender in the middle, you know, right off the bat, you're saying, now, this kind of sounds kind of weird, you know, but it's really, it's not bad. I mean, I have to be totally honest with you. $6.49, and it's pretty good. And they also have the combo, but I don't need that, you know. Just want to get you to spend a few more bucks. You know what? I've watched other reviews. You know what? The thing is, I don't want to do this review. I didn't want to wait on this because then I'll be just behind the bandwagon. So I wanted to jump on this as soon as possible. I'm sure a lot of people have, a lot of food reviewers have put this out already, but at least I'm not, you know, in the bottom barrel of this, because once you get 1,000 of these reviews, my review means shit. Or they're really not going to pay attention to what I have to say, so. Because I'll just be hearing the same thing over and over again. But I thought I'd, there were some complaints about the donut, that it wasn't a Krispy Kreme donut. But no, man, it's still good. I like it. I thought they were going to throw a pickle in the middle. That would have been something else. So you'd have a pickle donut chicken sandwich. Take another bite. It's the weirdest sandwich I've ever eaten, man. Next thing you know, they'll be doing this with pizza and hamburgers. Oh, God. Well, I heard that Burger King has a... I give this a thumbs up, without question. But I heard the Burger King has this French fry sandwich now that they're... How the hell do you sell something like that? Who the hell would eat French fries trapped between two hamburger buns? I don't know, man. They're going to come up with gimmick. If they could sell, they're going to come up with gimmick after gimmick after gimmick after gimmick. Like I said, this was unheard of years ago. Unheard of. There was one sandwich that I liked back in the 80s that they did away with. They always do away with the good stuff. I think it was McDonald's had a chopped steak sandwich on a, it looked like meatloaf, but it wasn't. It was like more of a sirloin burger in the middle of a hero Italian, like an Italian bread hero. When they realize that they're giving you too much bang for the buck, they'll do away with it, man. That's how they are. That's how all these fast food places. You wait a minute, we're giving them a little too much, you know? Like the way when the Big Mac first, not the Big Mac, the Quarter Pounder when it first came out. Or as a matter of fact, the Big Mac, they were gigantic. And then they started undersizing and undersizing and undersizing to the point where, you know, it really wasn't worth it anymore. You look at the Big Mac now and it's like nothing. You could eat four or five of them, but, you know, pay attention to how many calories are in there, how much sodium is in there, and how much fat is in there, and it'll kill you. I gotta take one more bite. One for the road, as Ed Norton says, right? Another one of them cookies, Bert. You know how to make them short. I got the glaze. This is good. I might come back later for more shit. You got your dessert, you got your sugar, and you got your chicken sandwich all rolled into one. Really good. Anyway, if you like what you see, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button. Make sure you share a lot, share a like. And leave a comment in the description box below. And I'll see you soon. This-